Often, at midday, I found myself fixed at a corner of the room, sitting on the carpeted floor with the drawing paper before me. How I wished my hand could freely move along, just playing fancifully round the idea, to etch something, sort of an image, in a mood of joyful abandon. Mellow sunbeams glowed at daybreak. The ecstasy of the merry world all around took me out as its dear playmate to join the duet of color and rhythm. At noon, the vast expanse of the open sky, the relaxed hours idling away, left me utterly enchanted. Night, that mysterious veiled lady beckoned me. I was glided delightfully along the hidden door, deep within the realms of an unknown dreamland. Perception of color by my conscious mind makes me see emerald green and ruby crimson red. Towards the sky, when I turn my eyes from east to west, it is all bright. I imagine a rose in bloom, the beauty of which I adore, and beautiful appears the rose. hunger for art and beauty was inborn with Rabindranath. The House of Tagore's at Jorasanko ushered in the Renaissance, the cultural rebirth of India, a new movement in literature, art, and culture. The environment pioneered a lasting liberal tradition, an era of enlightenment to reach the totality and diversity of life. Rabindranath inherited this cultural environment, was urged by the spirit of rediscovery of man in his creative art. In his unique literary creations, poetry, dramas, short stories, essays, novels, pictures and paintings. Shantiniketan is an anomaly not only in India but also in the world of today. Long ago, Maharshi Rabindranath Tagore, the father of the poet, built in Shantiniketan a charming retreat. It stands as an island of peace, a poet's dream amid carnage and terror, travail and turmoil. Only in Shantiniketan can one freely come and go. One can, in spite of the world, dream dreams. Artists can paint and poets can create. Shantiniketan has a personality of its own. When the scratches in my manuscript cried, like sinners, for salvation, and assailed my eyes with the ugliness of their irrelevance, I often took more time in rescuing them into a merciful finality of rhythm. The rhythm in thought, the rhythm in sound. A lively imagination, a natural dexterity, a fine flowing hand for calligraphy, and a sudden discovery of a hidden talent for self-expression through lines and colors. The reasons which explain the emergence of Rabindranath Tagore as a creative exponent of the modern Indian art at the age of 67. Thank you.
Thank you. Indeed.